Always follow your instinct, all right? Always follow your instincts. No one knows anything. You have to be critical of everyone you see and watch, and there are many reasons behind success and finding your diet, finding your sleep, finding all your patterns in life. Finding all your patterns in life will make you satisfied because when you do everything that you love, you'll always be satisfied. But that's why you gotta love all these things. That's how you find happiness. That's how you find life satisfaction. That's how you find true satisfaction. That's how you find your truth. I can only guide you. I can't find the truth for you, but I will do my best to guide you to find your instincts. That is what I want to do, you know, awaken your inner genius, as I call it. You should just follow whatever you want to do, but not aimlessly. You gotta still understand that you have to improve all life's essential areas of life. You have to improve, you know, your health, wealth, relationships. Everything boils down to health. From health, you go from health and then you move outwards. You go from your core and you move outwards because when you have parented yourself, when you have your routines and you love every routine you have, you'll just keep on going. This is the best method. This is the best way because you can do all these strategies as much as you want. You can count this, you can count that, you can plan this, and I will plan this out, and I will plan that out. No. And by the way, our ancestors didn't plan like that. They just, you know, they had some idea. They visualized, today I'm gonna find this bison and I will eat it. But it didn't happen every day, all right? They couldn't have the bison every day because nature is tough. Nature is super tough. Working on yourself is the most important thing you can do. You have to invest in yourself. You have to find a self-interest in yourself. You gotta work on all these things. When you work on all these things, your life will be much better. You will have full potential. You'll reach full potentiality. That is how you reach full potentiality. You reach full potentiality by improving all the small parts in your life because when all the small parts work well, the larger parts will work way better. That's how you reach full potentiality. Full potentiality doesn't just mean you go beyond yourself in some abstract sense. No, it is very physical, it is very mental, it is very real. And you do it by finding your diet, finding your exercise, finding your sleep, finding your meditation. You find those are the core things. Now, there are other stuff like relationships, health, well, health, all of it is health, but relationships and, you know, money or whatever it is, finding your passion and stuff like that. But you find all of those things once you find your core, once you create your core, and once you constantly refine, you constantly remove your old self and you constantly renew yourself. You have a new self every day, all the time, every day. So you redefine yourself. I don't want to be this, I want to be this. Well, I not just want to be this, I'm going to acquire this quality. And then when you're there, you will realize, you can only realize when you're there. Like, for example, once you have your six-pack abs, a lot of people want to have a six-pack abs. You reach there, once you reach there, you'll realize how nothing it is. It is nothing. You don't care much about belly fat. Maybe a little bit if you gain it back, but once you gain back, you know, you feel a bit down perhaps, and that you've regressed, but you haven't regressed because you've added some fat. But then you train again. You train harder because you're heavier, and so you train and you gain more muscle. And then you fast a little bit again, and then you remove the belly fat, and there you are again. You're in perfect condition again. So it is about perfecting the human condition. You see, I even mentioned the regular word for condition there, and it makes perfect sense with a human condition. That is what the human condition is. So here, in Mitkovsky philosophy land, we combine philosophy and fitness and health and nutrition and whatever it is. That's why it's called Mitkovsky philosophy. This is my philosophy. I explain my health philosophy. So perhaps the channel should be Mitkovsky health or Mitkovsky health philosophy or life philosophy. But it doesn't matter because philosophy should be aiding life. Philosophy should always aid life. That's the way Aristotle saw it. That's the way Seneca saw it. Marcus Aurelius, Plato, all of these thinkers in the past behind us, all these great people, according to many people. So if you want to reach your full potential, you want to perfect the human condition, you have to work on all of these things, and nothing that is great is fast. Everything that is great takes time. Everything that is great takes time. You got to accept that everything that is great takes time. Work on your vision. Don't abandon your vision. Follow your instincts, and it will become a reality. It will become a reality by your own actions, by actions. You can't make it a reality by only thinking. You can't just think your way out of everything. You gotta think and you gotta do. You gotta do both. You can't just do stuff either. You have to think a little bit. You gotta have self-doubts. You gotta search within yourself as well. You gotta step back, look at everything, and just, you know, see it objectively. You gotta see yourself objectively and understand where your steps went wrong. And eventually you'll find your people, because you will attract the people you want. Because if you improve yourself, if you become the perfected human condition, if you become, you know, the greater part of yourself, others will see this, it will radiate, and others will see this, they want to have some part of that, and they want to know your secrets, your skills. And there are no secrets. The secret is loving all the parts of your life. That is the only secret there is. There is no secret. The secret to happiness, the secret to happiness and life happiness, is just doing what you love. But not just doing what you love. A lot of people speak of doing what you love. You have to do the stuff to realize what you love. You can't even understand what you love until you do it. You don't understand if you like calisthenics until you try calisthenics. You don't know if you like the gym or doing, you know, all these dumbbell exercises until you do them. And I did them. I did them for 3 months. I did dumbbell exercises for 3 months and I didn't like it. Sometimes I actually go back and I do some stuff, but it is not for, you know, it is not a proper thing. I just, you know, sometimes you're just playful and you just try things out, but, and you follow your instincts. Perhaps you feel like you want to do that. Perhaps you feel like going to the gym instead of doing the calisthenics, and that's fine. But you will always return to your calisthenics or whatever it is. But you find what you love, but you find it through doing it. And I remember now that I think of it, like, all these, some YouTubers having these six-pack abs and stuff like that. And once you have it, it becomes nothing. It's, all right, well, it makes you more confident, of course, but all of this stuff will make you more confident. When you have a confident core, when you have confidence, when you have health, wealth, you have confidence. And once you have health and wealth, and once you have confidence, once you are able and capable of bringing back the hunt to the tribe, to your family, and share it and so forth, once you can do that reliably, that's when you'll have confidence, that's when your life begins, that's when everything happens. You stop thinking about people's opinion, you stop looking just at results, you look at where you are, your current state, and then what your higher desire is. Is your higher desire to do this or this thing? And you define it, try to clearly define it, and you get there. But you might not know yet where your desire is even. You only know that you want to be more healthy, you know, you want to be healthier. And that is fine. That is how I started. I started with changing my diet. I just wanted to be healthy. I just wanted to fix my mood swings. Just wanted to fix, you know, depression, seasonal depression. I just wanted to fix, you know, food addiction and all that stuff. And, you know, I was lethargic and stuff like that. I always produced stuff. I always did, you know, I always did my philosophy. I always did my art. And I still do. If you have any problems with this, you can contact me. The email is down below. Check my Facebook page, group, join the group. Comment down below if you have any questions about any of this. Like I always say, keep on working on yourself. Keep on focusing on yourself. Everything will be great. Everything will be fine. And I will see you people tomorrow.